Hello, I'm Kairono from Physiology Department, School of Medical Sciences, University Science, Malaysia. In this video, we are going to talk about ventilation-perfusion ratios. First, we are going to learn what is ventilation-perfusion ratios, followed by matching and mismatching of ventilation-perfusion ratio, or also called ventilation-perfusion defects. The ventilation-perfusion ratio, or VQ ratio, is the ratio of alveolar ventilation to pulmonary blood flow, or perfusion. Ventilation is the air coming into the alveolar per minute, whereas perfusion is the amount of blood flowing through the capillaries per minute. Ideally, the ventilation and perfusion should match perfectly, and the ratio should be 1. For gas exchange, meaning ventilation should be equal to perfusion. However, normally during normal tidal volume, normal cardiac output and breathing frequency, the lung has VQ ratio of 0.8. It means that alveolar ventilation is 80% of perfusion. There is more perfusion than ventilation. The value of 0.8 is the average VQ for the entire lung. The lungs basically can be divided into three zones. In the video entitled Perfusion, we have learned that perfusion is highest at the base and lowest at the apex. This is due to gravitational effects. Similarly, ventilation is also higher at the base and lower at the apex. However, although both ventilation and perfusion is higher at the base and lower at the apex, the regional variations in ventilation are not as great as regional variations in perfusion. At the apex, ventilation is reduced, but perfusion is even more reduced, so the VQ ratio becomes higher. The VQ ratio is around 3 at the apex, meaning there is more ventilation than perfusion. So this is called wasted ventilation. At the base, ventilation is higher, but perfusion is even higher. So the VQ ratio becomes lower. The VQ ratio at the base is around 0.6. Meaning there is more perfusion than ventilation. So this is called wasted perfusion. So normally, regardless of the zone, the average VQ ratio of the entire lung is 0.8. The VQ ratio can increase almost up to 1 during exercise. During exercise, cardiac output increases, capillaries dilated, so there is increased perfusion, especially at the apex. When the ratio of ventilation and perfusion is 1 to 1, this is called matching of VQ ratio. When ventilation or perfusion is higher or lower than one another, this is called mismatching of VQ ratio. When ventilation is more than perfusion, VQ ratio will be more than 1. So this is considered high, which means more gas exchange. When ventilation is lower than perfusion, VQ ratio is less than 1, meaning the VQ ratio is low. Gas exchange is less than ideal. VQ ratio will determine the partial pressure of gas at that particular region. Normally, atmospheric air has a partial pressure of oxygen of 150 mm mercury and that of carbon dioxide is 0. Alveolar air has 100 of oxygen, 40 carbon dioxide. When VQ ratio is normal or 0.8, gas exchange process can occur normally. So arterial pressure of oxygen and carbon dioxide equilibrate with alveolar air. So it is also 140. While venous blood has 40 oxygen and 46 carbon dioxide. So low oxygen and higher carbon dioxide. When there is a VQ mismatch, the gas exchange process is abnormal. So the pressures of oxygen and carbon dioxide will also change accordingly. At the lowest end, VQ ratio can be as low as zero. This is when there is perfusion, but no ventilation. Ventilation is zero. VQ ratio of zero is called right to left shunt. It is wasted perfusion. Blood passes through without being oxygenated. It can occur in right to left cardiac shunts or when there is airway obstruction. In right to left shunt, gas exchange is not possible because there is no ventilation to deliver oxygen to the blood or to carry away carbon dioxide from the blood. Because the blood is not oxygenated, arterial carbon dioxide and oxygen is the same as that of venous blood. Arterial oxygen is 40 mm mercury and carbon dioxide is 46 mm mercury. At the highest end, VQ ratio can be infinity. This is when there is ventilation but no perfusion. This region with VQ ratio of infinity is dead space. Dead space is ventilation of lung regions that are not perfused. The ventilation is wasted. Dead space can occur in pulmonary embolism, where blood flow to a portion or the entire lung is occluded. Ventilation is there, but there is no perfusion. In dead space, gas exchange is also not possible because there is no blood flow to receive oxygen from alveolar gas or to add carbon dioxide to alveolar gas. So, the alveolar pressure of oxygen and carbon dioxide will be equal to the inspired atmospheric air. Alveolar pressure of oxygen is 150 mm mercury and carbon dioxide is zero. When a lung region has a low VQ ratio, the region has low ventilation relative to perfusion. So it can either mean that ventilation is reduced more than perfusion, or ventilation is increased but perfusion is even more increased. Usually, VQ ratio is low because ventilation is decreased. Unlike shunt, which has no ventilation at all, low VQ regions have some ventilation. Because ventilation is low relative to perfusion, gas exchange is also low. So therefore, pulmonary capillary blood from this region has a low pressure of oxygen and high pressure of carbon dioxide. Low VQ ratio can occur in pneumonia, chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, asthma, or pulmonary edema. On the other hand, when a lung region has high VQ ratio, the region has high ventilation relative to perfusion. So, it can either mean that ventilation is increased more than perfusion, or ventilation is reduced, but perfusion is even more reduced. Usually, VQ ratio is high because perfusion is decreased. Unlike dead space, which has no perfusion at all, high VQ regions have some perfusion. Because ventilation is high relative to perfusion, gas exchange is also high. Therefore, pulmonary capillary blood from these regions has a high pressure of oxygen and low pressure of carbon dioxide. High VQ ratio can be seen in pulmonary embolism or emphysema. So that's all for matching and mismatching of ventilation perfusion ratios. Thank you for watching.